This video is going to be about finding the nth term of an arithmetic sequence. So let's get started. Here I've got a sequence, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15. And to get from one term to the next, I keep adding a 2. I take the 7, add a 2 and get a 9, add another 2 and get an 11, add 2 again and get 13, and so on. So basically that means I've got an arithmetic sequence and the common difference would be 2. So I'm going to write D for common difference equals 2. And since the sequence has an ellipsis at the end of it, meaning that, you know, those three dots, meaning that it keeps going, I could continue this. And in fact, somebody might ask me, what's term number 105? And so I guess what I'd have to do would be to keep adding twos until I got 105 terms, and then I'd have the answer for them. But there's a faster way, and here's how we're going to do it. I'm going to make two columns. In the first column, I'm just going to write the number of the term. So I could write like 1, 2, 3, but I'm going to use a slightly different notation. I'm going to call the first term A sub 1. The second term I'll call A sub 2. The third term I'll call A sub 3, and so on. And then in the second column, I'll write whatever that term is. So the A sub 1, or the first term, would be a 7. The A sub 2, the second term, is a 9, but I get 9 by adding 2 to the previous term. So let's write that as 7 plus 2. Now, if I want to get the third term, the A sub 3, I would add a 2 to that. So that would be 7 plus 2 plus 2 more. For A sub 4, I would write 7 plus 2 plus 2, the previous term, and then once again, plus 2. Now, of course, there's a faster way to write this. If I keep adding on 2s, then basically I could take something like this fourth term, 7 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2. There are three 2s. So that would be 7 plus 3 times 2. The term before that, where I've added two 2s, would be 7 plus 2 times 2. The term before that, which only has one 2, would be 7 plus, let's call that 1 times 2, so I keep multiplying the 2s. And the first term, which is just a 7, well, if I want to add something that's a multiple, I would say 7 plus 0 times 2. And now looking at this, I can see a relationship between the number of the term and the number I used to multiply that common difference. So for term number 1, I multiplied the common difference, the 2, by a 0. For term number 2, I multiplied by 1. Term number 3, I multiplied by 2. Term number 4, I multiplied by 3. So I'm multiplying the common difference, the 2, by the number that is 1 less than the number of the term. So if I wanted to find some term which we'll call term n, or the nth term, I would keep the same pattern going. I would say, oh, that must be 7 plus, let's see, I want the number less than the number of the term that I have. So the number less than n would be n minus 1. I'm going to multiply that times 2. So a rule for this sequence would be that the nth term, or whatever term I want to use for n, whatever number, would be 7 plus n minus 1 times 2. So let's go back to that problem of what's term number 105. So I'm going to take 7 plus, let's see, 105 minus 1 instead of n minus 1, 105 minus 1 times 2, and that's going to equal 7 plus 105 minus 1 is 104, so 104 times 2. Well, 2 times 104 is going to be 208, so that'll be 7 plus 208. And 7 plus 208 would be 215. So the 105th term, or I could call that A sub 105, would be 215. So now that I've got a formula, now that I've got a way to find any term at all for this specific arithmetic sequence, let's see if we can extend that and find a formula for finding any term for any arithmetic sequence. So starting with the formula I have for this sequence, which was that the nth term is 7, which was actually the first term I used, a sub 1, plus n minus 1 times 2, which is the common difference. Why don't I just change that to, instead of 7, I'll call that a sub 1. That's the number we used for the first term. And then I'm going to add that to the product of n minus 1, n being the number of the term I'm looking for, n minus 1, times, instead of 2, times d, which was the common ratio. I'm sorry, the common difference. So now that means I've got a formula for finding any term of any arithmetic sequence. I'm going to take the first term, the a sub 1, and then to that I will add n minus 1, the number of the term minus 1, and multiply that by the common difference. So my formula will be a sub 1 plus n minus 1 multiplied by d. Okay? Using this formula, you could take whatever arithmetic sequence you have, plug in the first term, plug in the common difference, and then for whatever term number you want, put that in where the n is. Okay? So that's about it for this one. Take care. I'll see you next time.